Peace, love, and light. Welcome to day 11 of 30 days of mudras. And today we're going to talk about the air mudras. Now, when dealing with the mudras with this elemental focus, the attention is on the index finger. Now, the air element mudras relate to the element of air and to the heart chakra, which governs the relationship that you have with yourself. Your index finger is the one that you use to make points. When it comes to yoga philosophy, it is said that it represents your ego, that principle that causes you to experience yourself as separate from everything else in the world. Now, practicing any of these mudras that we learn related to this air element is going to help to ensure that your heart chakra and air energy is healthy and balanced. Now, in this way, they help you to develop greater personal freedom, enhances your compassion and have a more joyous way of life. They also reduce your stress levels. You can't see the air element, but you can experience it through sense of touch and through hearing. Now, in Sanskrit, air is called vayu, a term that includes all matter in gaseous form, that's including but not limited to the air that we breathe, steam, and wind. Now, the attributions of the air element are restless movement, the ability to expand, and dryness. Now, air has the quality of what is known in yogic terms as rajas, meaning that one of its defining traits is to want to move constantly. If you know people with a lot of air in their chart, even astrologically, you know that these are individuals who do not like to sit still. Now, in Ayurveda, the elements of air and ether make up the Vata dasha, which is the motivating force behind the other two dashas, which is Pitta and Kapha, as we've mentioned before. Now, Vata moves, it achieves goals. Without Vata, the dashas will become stuck and stagnant. However, too little as well as too much movement can cause problems. An imbalance of Vata can contribute to the variety of mental and nervous disorders, such as insomnia, mental and physical paralysis, dizziness, and feelings of grief. Now, you can bring back your Vata energy by practicing the mudras and exercises that are given to you when we talk about the air element. And your index finger is connected with your anahata, or heart chakra, the energetic center of your body and the seat of the air element. This is also the base of your prana, the non-physical energy that's often referred to as vital air. In the physical body, this chakra governs respiration and circulation. And if you have respiratory or any circulatory problems, you really may want to begin working with some of the air mudras and associated exercises that are provided as we talk about different air mudras. The heart chakra also transmutes the higher vibrations from the upper three chakras into grosser forms so that they can manifest on the physical plane. In other words, it transforms consciousness into matter or thoughts into deeds. For example, you may have a great idea, but before you can act on it, you must take it to heart. Emotionally, if you are feeling stifled or suffocated by life, lacking joy, perhaps it's time for a change. Maybe a change of air. Working with air mudras can help you to feel more confident, while they simultaneously make your mind and body feel lighter and more carefree. Freeing your energy in this way is like taking a breath of fresh air, and it helps you to experience life with fewer mental limitations. As the seat of your love and compassion, your heart is probably the most complex of the chakras. Above all, as you begin to work with these air mudras, you will begin to feel its effects as you notice yourself becoming more and more empathetic. Working with these air mudras will assist you in opening up your heart chakra. I look forward to sharing these air mudras with you this coming week. Peace.